Hello, everybody. My name is Daniel Kim. Today is June 1st, 2019. Today I would like to talk about date of second coming based on the Proverbs. As we all know, Proverbs. This is written by King Solomon. And King Solomon, he is the king of wisdom. And if you read 1 Kings chapter 3 verse 12, God promised him he will be the wisest person. In the human history. So we know the King Solomon, he is the wisest person in the human history. And Proverbs chapter 1, verse 6, it says, if we read these Proverbs, we will understand mystery or dark saying, or you can say puzzle. And then if you go Proverbs 7:20, it says, husband, come home on full moon. So this is the clue. We know husband means Jesus. And full moon, it is in the Jewish calendar, 15th day of the month. So when you think about the full moon, there are 7 feast days. And among these 7 feast days, there are 2 full moon. One is Abib 15, and the other one is Tishri 15th. And this is Passover, and this is a Feast of Tabernacle. But when you think about Exodus, it was on Abib 15. This one. And when you think about arrival to Promised Land, it was on Abib 15th too. So departure date and arrival date was the same date. And Exodus means crucifixion. And arrival to the Promised Land, this is means second coming. Because if you read Hebrew chapter 11, verse 16, the second coming means we are coming to the hometown in heaven. So the crucifixion means this is high Sabbath. And Bible says high day. And high day is Abib 15. So second coming will be on high Sabbath. It is Revelation chapter 6, 17 and 16, 14. It says high day. High means great. Great day. Great and dreadful day of Jehovah. So we can understand Jesus is coming back on Abib 15th. This is a full moon. Let's look at further. When you think about Luke chapter 23, 43, Jesus told the criminal right next to him, "Truly, I say unto you, today you will be with me in the paradise." So this today, it is Abib 14th, 3 p.m. This is the time Jesus passed away. And this is the beginning of Abib 15th, full moon. So when you think about John 5:25, "The time is coming when the dead hear the voice of Son of Man, and that will be sometime now." And John 5:1, it was a Passover feast. So when just say, "The time is coming when the dead will hear the voice of Son of Man, and that will be sometime now." So now means Passover. So when Jesus passed away on the cross, Matthew chapter 27, 50 to 52, when Jesus cried out and he gave away His spirit, there was a big earthquake, and the saint who was sleeping in the tomb, the tomb was open, and they came out of the grave. So the John 5:25, this is linked to Matthew 27, 50 to 52. So this is the prophecy, and this is the fulfillment. And this is a preliminary fulfillment, and the second coming will be ultimate fulfillment. So when Jesus is coming back, that exact time will be Abib 14th, 3 p.m. This is the date and hour. So Jesus is coming back on Abib 15th, and Abib 14th, 3 p.m., this is the beginning of Abib 15th. So brothers and sisters, as I mentioned earlier, Proverbs 7:20, husband, come home on full moon. And this is Abib 15th. Jesus is beginning, and he is also ending. He is Alpha and also Omega. So Jesus died on the cross on Abib 14th, 3 p.m. And he set us free from sin. So Exodus date. Abib 15th and second coming also Abib 15th full moon, and it will be 2030 April 18th. This is a full moon date. And if you read Hosea 6:2, after 2 days, he will revive us. So, when you think about the crucifixion, it was on April 5th, 30 AD. And the second coming is April 18th, 2030. So this is a little bit over 2000 years. So this means after 2 days. When you read John 2:19 through 21, destroy this temple, I will raise it up in 3 days. And he was referring to his body, body of Christ. And body of Christ means church. This is Ephesians chapter 1, 23. The body of Christ means church. So he is building, raise up his church. 3 days means 3,000 years. This is based on 2 Peter 3:8 and Matthew 16:18. Jesus promised Peter he will give keys of the kingdoms of heaven to Peter. So Peter, he understood to the Lord one day is 1,000 years. So Jesus is building New Jerusalem. So this is a plan of New Jerusalem construction. It is 3,000 years exact. And Jesus was resurrected 30 AD. It was April 9th. This is a resurrection. And 3,000 years means 3,030 April 9th. This is Abib 14th and 3 p.m. This is New Jerusalem. So we know there is the millennium. So 2030, this is second coming. Plus the millennium, 1,000 years. So 3,030, this is New Jerusalem. So brothers and sisters, if you study Bible very carefully, you will fully understand Jesus is coming back 2030. If you go to Joshua, chapter 3, let me look at it. Chapter 3, verse 4. You know, there is a Jordan River, and the people were following the covenant. And the Levite, they are crossing this Jordan River first, and the people and this covenant, the Ark of the Covenant, is 2,000 cubit. The distance between the Ark of the Covenant and the people, there should be 2,000 cubits, space. So this 2,000 means 2,000 years. So Jesus went across the Jordan River in 30 AD. So we are going to cross this river at 2030 AD. So if you study the Bible very carefully, you will understand Jesus died in the year of 30 AD. So you will instantly understand Jesus is coming back 2030. If you want to understand this secret, you must understand Matthew 12:40. 3 days and three nights. Jesus, he died on Wednesday and resurrected on Sunday in 30 AD. Brothers and sisters, we are truly nearing to the end of the times, so open your mind and study the Bible as is. Jesus, he truly died on Wednesday and resurrected on Sunday in 30 AD. You need to read Matthew 12:40 and Genesis 1:5 and 16 and John 11:9 and also 8:25. If you have any question, please leave your comment. We want the truth, and we also want to understand the prophecy, so that we can campaign for the second coming of Jesus. God bless you.